To have an opportunity to see another edition of the Al Mccray Show. We are a Tampa Bay news and talk show, and as you already know, we have many type of people and guests on our show. We're holding our show at the Urban Culinary Cuisine in New Tampa, where the proprietors are Rose and John Sykes. Today on my show, guess who we have? Well, we have Mr. Thomas Scott. Is it president of the city council or head of the city council?
Chairman of the city council.
Oh, excuse me. Mr. Scott, chairman of Tampa City Council. Thank you for being here today.
Thank you for inviting me.
Now, where do we get started? This is my car. I have this big person. This is my car somewhere. I must give this this announcement. Anything I say or my guests say are strictly my comment or their comments. And I may slip sometime, okay? And, my viewers know I speak with a Negro dialect, so if you don't understand me, you may have to pause, rewind, and play it again, okay? So I got disclaimers out there. Thank you. Now, what do you do in the city council again?
Currently, I'm the chairman of Tampa City Council, which is my third consecutive term serving as chairman for the city council, which means I chair the meetings, call the meeting to order, and that sort of thing. Guide the whole process every Thursday. We meet every Thursday.
Is that a ceremonial position or is that power? So what would you
say? Well, the charter calls for 4 votes as a majority.
Okay.
So city council can't do anything without having 4 votes or any kind of way in terms of making a decision.
But being chairman
allows me to set the agenda.
Make appointments?
Allows me to make appointments to various boards and committees. Mm-hmm. It allows me, in the absence of the mayor, so for instance, if the mayor is out of the country, generally technically the chairman then becomes
the de facto mayor.
Right, okay. Or the mayor resigns, then the chairman becomes the mayor.
Now recently, the city council made history. You have three Negroes, that's left. We have 3 African Americans on the city council. That's history by itself.
Yes.
I'm shocked. Okay. Not to mention anybody's name in particular, but there was a minor controversy because y'all did not have in place a qualifying mechanism for appointing city council members.
Well, that's not quite accurate. They had a process in place because they've done this before.
Okay.
If you go back several terms, they did this when Kevin White and Rose Valita left. They appointed 2 people to the city, who was Chip Fletcher and Frank Redding.
Well, let me phrase that a little bit so I've been correct here. It was a 2-minute process.
Yes, 2-minute process. Okay. In terms of giving an overview of who you are, but there is an application for you to fill out. So we have an opportunity to review the application as a form, an application that you fill out that we have opportunity to review.
We all modify that now because of the latest appointment? Ask more questions about financial background?
Yeah, I think that's a legitimate question and a legitimate concern. I think that's something that will be added to the process, added to the form or the questionnaire.
It take more than 2-minute interview, you think? More than 2 minutes?
Well, it depends on how many applicants. I mean, this time we had 6 to 8 applicants.
Okay.
That's a lot of people. You know, and so if you give more time than that, you're looking at all day and probably two days of hearing testimony, hearing persons talk about themselves.
You know, on TV when they're state appointments or federal appointments, there's some sort of committee that go through these applicants, and they screen their background, etc. You think the city government may have a screening committee, a separate?
My suggestion was that. My suggestion was, why don't you put in place a screening process where you narrow it down, let's say, to the top 20.
Okay.
I got voted down. that here again, that's a good example of needing 4 votes. And so that was rejected. But I did offer that because coming from the background of the county commission, what we generally, when we hire a county administrator, an attorney, we will always have someone to narrow down, let's say, to the top 10 applicants, and then we will interview the top 10.
Okay.
Which allows for more time, to raise questions, give them more time to deliberate, that sort of thing. But I agree with you, 2 minutes. It's not a lot of time. Two minutes when you come up. It's not a whole lot you can say in 2 minutes.
Okay. Well, hopefully it'll work out in the future. Now, there's a lot going on in the city government now, especially with the economy now. Yeah. What role do you play in trying to fix the deficit in the county, city government now? What role do you play in budget alignment?
Well, based on the charter of the city, the mayor has the responsibility to present the budget to city council, just like the president of the United States has the responsibility, constitute him the authority to present the budget. To comment at that point, then it becomes our budget. So it becomes our budget at city council. We have an opportunity to look through the budget, go through the budget. We can change things around, even though the mayor has veto power, or we can change things in the budget and the mayor does not have to spend it. Okay? But pretty much the mayor generally gives us a balanced budget. And then we go through the line item by item to review.
You can line item veto things,
I don't know. Yeah, well, you can change the budget around anything. We can change it around that the mayor has in there. But you don't, again, just because I move it, or just because I change things around, that does not mean that the mayor is going to spend those dollars. That's the other thing. The charter is structured where you have a strong mayor form of government.
But people are complaining about you reducing the policeman, yet you're paying $100,000 for artwork.
Well, actuality, my understanding was that the mayor had in the budget about $21,000 or $22,000 for artwork, and there had not been any reduction in the police force because that was one area that had been preserved. The first year I was on city council, almost 4 years ago, there was no cuts in the public safety area, fire or police.
Okay.
The cuts were actually in Parks and Recreation. They took a major hit. And then this last budget cycle, there were no cuts in police or fire, even though there were no filling of vacancies by the administration through attrition. She did not, fill those vacancies.
Where were the greatest cut in the city budget this year for the cuts economy?
We are going through that process now. Looking at, the mayor just gave it to us, last week.
Okay.
And so we just got it. So we're looking at that now.
What do you envision the most cuts going to be?
Again, I think that when you look at the budget, what the mayor has presented, it has been where she did not fill positions.
Okay.
And she cut her top staff. She started with administration.
Fired, eliminated, or reduced her pay?
Elimination of administrative position.
Really? That's,
yeah,
pretty heavy duty.
Yeah, yeah. A lot of positions got eliminated in the administration area.
But sometimes when they cut out this person's job, they kind of recycle them to another position in city government.
No, that didn't happen. That's not happening. And part of the issue now, given the constraints that we're under with a tight budget, you're finding now that people are having their shorter help. You're having now maybe one person doing multiple things,
okay,
and it's taking you longer now to get things, get information, get to people because of that. So that's a reality now.
Okay. Well, what we're gonna do, for those of you who know, we have multiple panelists here. I like the word grill. We gotta talk to Mr. Scott here about topics. And the first one is gonna be Miss Ella Coffey. She's in the house. Anyone seen Ella Coffey? Oh, there she is in the corner. Ella Coffey, please come over here and sit. I think y'all know each other.
Oh yes.